guys are doing such an awesome job. Thank you so much. So I have a question. Is anybody going trick-or-treating tomorrow? Yeah? Do you have a costume? I mean, what are you going to be? What's your costume? An angry bird. Excellent. What's your costume? The Flash. Very cool. Flash Gordon. Do you have a costume? A princess? Cool. Yeah, that's to make your voice sound louder. Do you have a
costume? No, are you too old for this?
Yes.
Definitely, I understand.
Do you have a costume for Halloween?
What?
I'm Batman.
Batman.
Ghostface.
That sounds scary. Do you have a costume for Halloween?
No.
Do you?
Michelle?
No.
Do you have a costume, Stacy? What is it?
Hannah Montana. A throwback. Nice. So when I was your age, there was one house across the street from me and a couple houses down, and it was the best house in the neighborhood to go trick-or-treating at. Do you know why?
Why?
They gave you a whole full-size candy bar.
Oh,
yes. Right? Do you have one of those? Where is that house?
Like, up the street from you.
What's the best? Do you have the best house to get candy at?
Yeah.
At home? Yeah, Errol, do you have the best house? Gave you a big orange thing? Cool. I like it. So, Halloween, you know, is like kind of a weird American holiday, right? Trick-or-treating. But there is a church holiday that's the day after. Does anybody know what that church holiday is? What is it? The day after Halloween. Two months. The day after Halloween. What is it? Do you know? So in like Latin America, we call it the Day of the Dead, because what's the next day?
Oh,
yeah.
Jesus died.
Not quite, that's Easter, that's in the spring. The day after Halloween is called All Saints Day. So what does that mean? What's a saint? Any ideas? What's a saint? Not really a spirit or ghost, yeah. People who talk about God?
Satan?
Yeah? No, that would be the opposite of a saint. So a saint is somebody traditionally who does something that is really great, that's really faithful, and that serves God. But you all heard about Mother Teresa recently became a saint, right? But in our tradition, in the Presbyterian Church, we believe that anybody who believes in Jesus is called a saint. So you all are saints. Why don't you turn around and say hello to the saints?
Hello.
Hello, saints.
Hello, other saints.
Hello.
So on All Saints Day, we remember people who have done something good for us who maybe aren't with us anymore. So here's an example. What does it say on the window here? Can anybody read that?
Are
Mr. and Mrs. Alex McConnell here?
No.
Oh, they're not here.
They're dead.
But they did something pretty great for us, right? They gave us that beautiful window. And so they're saints of our community. The best thing about All Saints Day, though, is that people don't have to be gone from us in order for us to appreciate them, right? In the reading that we heard, Paul, who you could also call a saint, right? Paul wrote a lot of the books in the Bible. He told us a lot about God. Paul says, whenever he remembers his friends, he gives thanks for them. So who are people that we give thanks for that we know? Anybody?
Everyone.
Okay. Friends? Who do we give thanks for? Family? Animals? Yeah. Your life? Uh-huh. Who do you give thanks for? Jesus? Good. God? Who else do we give thanks for?
Pastor.
Oh, very good. Very good. Daniel? ask us, yeah. We give thanks for all the people who teach us, who take care of us, who love us. So we're going to practice doing that in a minute. But first, we're going to sing a song together. Do you guys know Jesus Loves Me? Okay, we're going to stand up all together and sing Jesus Loves Me.
Thank you. And at that time in their service, when we bring our prayers and concerns to the Lord, are there any prayers this morning?
Prayers for Tracy and all the kids that are applying to colleges. That's what we are doing, actually. So prayers for that.
Prayers for Tracy and all the kids who are applying for colleges, what they're getting. God of mercy.
A friend of mine walked, his house went down to the ground, and him and some other people have no place to stay today.
Prayers for Bob. Rob, sorry. Prayers for Bob's house. God of mercy.
Hear our prayer.
Remember, I brought brought out this map the other week to talk to you about the synods, the 17 different groups of churches in our country.
Yeah, I remember that. You were in Sunday school having a great time.
So each synod is made up of a bunch of presbyteries, which are smaller groups. As you know, we're members of Boston Presbytery. And our former pastor, who we gave thanks for, remember Pastor Sydney? Went on to become the staff leader of our presbytery. And today we are lucky to have with us my friend Kelsey, who is the unpaid leader and chief cat wrangler, I think. I'm not pastor. She's in a job called the moderator, where it's her job to make sure that people are paying attention, that they vote on things, that they come to committees and help do the work and make decisions together. So let's give Kelsey a big round of applause to welcome her.
Good morning. I've not been described as chief cat wrangler in the past, but it is a pretty good description of what I do. My name is Kelsey Rice Bogdan, and I'm a ruling elder at First Presbyterian Church in Brookline and the moderator of the Presbytery of Boston. I bring you greetings from First Brookline and from your sisters and brothers in Christ in the 22 other churches that make up the Presbytery of Boston. It's a joy to join you in worship today, and thank you, Meagan, for inviting me to be with you. Now, when we finalized this date several months ago, Pastor Meagan let me know that I would be coming on Children's Sunday. It should be noted, I tried to get my son to come up here with me, and he wouldn't do it. He bailed on me at the last minute, but what can you do? But I'm excited to be here with you on a day when the youth of the church are sharing leadership with adults. We older adults often underestimate the creativity, enthusiasm, and depth that young people bring to our worship when they have the opportunity to participate fully. The body of Christ is incomplete when we fail to recognize and celebrate their gifts as part of our corporate life. So now there may be children here today, and adults, who are wondering, what is a presbytery? It sounds like maybe Pastor Meagan is giving you some insight into that, and there are many ways to answer the question. But today I want to tell you a little bit about what a presbytery is to me. So the Bible tells us that we are children of God through Jesus, a family of faith. So when you're at church then, you're with your family. Old and young, rich and poor, black, white, brown, gay and straight. Everyone works together to love one another and help each other. Well, a presbytery is like an extension of your church family. We're kind of like the aunts and uncles and cousins that you would see at Christmas. Because what we Presbyterians call the presbytery is just our name for the other churches in our family. So just like you have a Presbyterian church here in Clinton, I'm part of a Presbyterian church nearby in Brookline. There are also Presbyterian churches in Worcester, Boston, Whitensville, all over the area. But all these churches are still part of one family, one body of Christ. So leaders of our churches get together, just like you get together with your aunts and uncles and cousins. When we meet, we eat, of course, because what would any family gathering be if we didn't eat? We talk, we make decisions together. And sometimes, like in all families, we disagree. But also, like a family, we help one another in ways big and small. In our Presbytery of Boston family, one way we help one another is to help people start new churches. So this year we've given prayers, advice, and money to Presbyterian Shekinah, a new Brazilian faith community that started up in Lowell, expanded to Brockton, and is right now planting a church in Natick. Just over 2 weeks ago, the Natick community accepted 19 new members. We've also helped Kenyan communities, Ghanaian communities, communities of young adults to start new churches here in Boston. And we're all with those communities, supporting them every time they baptize a new believer or teach a child the love of God. We also help one another learn how better to follow Jesus, or as Pastor Meagan just told you all, to be disciples of Jesus. In Sunday school, we learned that Jesus loves all of us, whether we were born in Cameroon or Korea, Brazil or America, or anywhere else. And in the Bible, Jesus teaches us how to love one another. But sometimes we don't do a good job of that, especially when we look differently from one another. So this year, our presbytery is asking everyone in our larger church family, including your church, to pray together, to study together, and to listen to one another's stories about our different experiences around race and culture. We started sharing those stories the last time we met as a presbytery in September. Right before our next presbytery meeting in November, you're all invited to come and join us to talk about a book that people are reading right now called Waking Up White. And the presbytery is going to give all of our churches books for Sunday school studies on how we can better love one another across our differences. So as a presbytery, we're growing and learning together in discipleship. Finally, our presbytery family works together to help people in our wider communities. Through our presbytery, young adults come from all over the United States to work in our churches and bring healthy food to people in our communities. 14 participants in the Young Adult Volunteer Program have served in 8 different churches over the past 4 years, helping those churches partner with community gardens, food pantries, nutrition programs, and policy organizations that are working to feed people who need it most. In my own church, First Brookline, our volunteers have helped us build a community garden alongside economically challenged women in Brookline. The Boston Food Justice Young Adult Volunteer Program is only one way that our churches work together to make a difference in our communities. So, in answer to the question, what is the presbytery? The Presbytery of Boston is your extended church family. And as a leader in that family this year, I can't tell you how grateful I am for all of you, my aunts, uncles, and cousins in this family of faith. Thank you for all the ways you supported the Presbytery of Boston here at Clinton Presbyterian Church, through your prayers, your service, and your financial support. Your sister churches are deeply grateful for your commitment to our shared witness to the gospel. Because we are all one family, or as the Apostle Paul says, one body. If one member suffers, all suffer together with it. If one member is honored, all rejoice together with it. Together, we are the body of Christ in Eastern Massachusetts, suffering with one another and offering support, rejoicing with one another as we go deeper in discipleship and mission. And we know that every member of the body is indispensable, from Clinton to Burlington, Easton to Boston. Thank you for ministering with us in the Presbytery of Boston.
One thing that the money we give does in our church is make sure there are resources for Sunday school and adult education. We are so glad that this many values learning and growing. Please contribute to offerings so that more children can learn and grow. First, we will take up a Griffin birthday offering, followed by a regular offering. Will someone lead us in a prayer?